Welcome to the Gallim Kitchen, and today I'm gonna make you one red pea soup. All right, let's go. So you know, so you have to bring out your pressure cooker and my electric some and my peas and we did a soak with some garlic and some pimento. So yeah, me just rinse them off and me just drop it in this soup me and pressure cooker. And then just put some scallion in there just to give some flavor in. And then you know, somebody get some nice fresh thyme. They have to smell it. When me tell you, say the fragrance from the thyme just make me just want. Remember, me tell you, it's so good. Yeah, I'm gonna just dash it right in the pressure cooker, and then I'm gonna add some more water just to top it off. All right, because a soup we are making now, I will make sure it's the peas and cook. And my time on my electric pressure cooker was 35 minutes, and then after 35 minutes now, me did check my peas, see if them soft, and me I tell you, say it did soft and nice, you know, just right. Then me gonna put in some goat skin. Me not even remember if I did goat skin or cow skin this, but either way, me I put this meat in it to get like a flavor. All right, then me just top it off with more water because yeah, we have to make sure say there's some cooking there. All right, so let's go. Get all confused which number me do you want put it on, but 35 minutes maybe put it on. So then after 35 minutes now, you know, so you cut up your vegetable them, and you have to check your peas and make sure say your meat after you cook. So now we're gonna drop in with scallion, with garlic, with thyme, with carrot, with pumpkin, any vegetable you want to put in your soup, you just dash it in your soup, and then you just let that slowly cook. I'm still I use my pressure cooker because it's also a slow cooker and it do a lot of things in it. All right, so I'm just going to stir in everybody, make sure everybody's just all right and good. You feel me? Yeah, what you know? Put in some more thyme. You can't forget the thyme. The thyme I will bring in the flavors in this bad boy. I tell you. Watch out. Look how me lose all the spoon tonight. So then, after when me take out the spoon now, me change the spoon now. So me just put in some, you know, some okra on the top because okra apparently is supposed to be a natural thickening agent. I may tell you, say, this is something that they make it thick. I'm gonna end up using some ram noodles. Me just still want to see how this is gonna turn out because the back of the bag say you can use it in any soup. But me tell you, say it did change the flavor of the soup, you know. I never understand it, but it's alright because the soup did taste nice. You feel me? So I'm just stirring everybody. I'm just leave it there so if it just go on bubble and simmer for just 30 more minutes. I'm gonna see everything was alright. So you know, so you just have a spoon out your soup in a nice clean bowl. I'm just obsessed with the bowl. I want me to find a winner / warm sense. And me I tell you, say that soup had a nice. Me never show no say me put in salt, but me put in a little bit of salt because me I try to lay off of the salt, even though salt bring up flavors, but it's alright. The soup did taste nice, alright? And this is how it did turn out. I'm hope say you tell your mom, papa, auntie, and uncle. I may tell you say cooking is not that hard and you can mess up and it is okay. So I love you. Bye.